This is Talk of the Town, a weekly program featuring community events happening in and around Northeast Michigan. With your host, Nancy Smitham, and get the latest from Alpena Community College with Dr. Don McMaster. And now, today's Talk of the Town.
Good morning and welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm Nancy Smitham. My first guest today is Brad Summers from the Boys and Girls Club of Alpena. Hi, Brad.
Hi, Nancy.
So glad to have you here, and the weather's finally here, but I know that your summer programming has kicked off with a bang.
Oh, absolutely. We really have hit the ground running. We've said in the past, and I've talked in the community about the fact that we were averaging summer numbers during the school year. And now that the summer is actually here, we're actually seeing a lot more attendance. So we're seeing, in between 100 and 125 kids every single day. And there's a lot of stuff actually going on in the community. So, yeah. As the summer progresses, we're gonna see more and more kids. But that's what we're here for.
Right.
We're here for that.
And you think of kids sitting home alone on a computer or a phone during those discretionary hours and what they may or may not be doing, or they can be at the Boys and Girls Club of Alpena with mentors and with their peers and everything, like the TV commercial, free, 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 free. Everything's free. I mean, if there is a membership cost, but everything once they get in the door is totally free.
Absolutely. We've really amped it up this year with the partnerships and collaborations in the community and offering more field trips, offering more ways that kids and parents can get engaged in the community and have something positive to do.
Yes.
And with the influx of kids that we've been seeing, we've hired some awesome people this summer to help us work, and a lot of them have been past members that I worked with.
That's wonderful.
A decade ago. So it's neat to be able to see kids that were 6, 7, 8 years old coming into the program, and now we're able to hire them to help us with their summer program while they're at home for college, from college or here visiting or whatever it is. But these are young people that know the programs. We always change things up and we do things a little bit differently, but this is, it's neat that, these young people have
Yes.
been part of the program and they have a rapport with us already, and, it's just neat to be able to reward that and see that.
Paying it forward, and you do it well.
Yeah, well, we try.
And, one of those collaborations we were just talking about is kids get to go out on the Lady Michigan.
Yeah, this is, this is the second year that we've been able to do this, and Noah contacted us and said, we would love to be able to offer the opportunity for 75 people from the club to be able to take advantage of a free boat ride to go out
Yes.
and seek adventure on the big lake, which is so cool. And some of these kids may not have this opportunity
That's
to
true.
Do this. I've only been able to do it a couple times,
Me
too. And it's a really neat opportunity, and for young people to be able to go out and be inspired by what's going on and what Noah's doing.
And it's in our backyard.
It's right there.
It's right there.
It's pretty cool.
And you're also doing a good collaboration with Art in the Loft.
Art in the Loft has been very generous. Justin Christensen Cooper has been very, just been awesome to work with. And all the people at Art in the Loft, they've been offering scholarships for the kids. We've been able to take kids over there. We walk from the club, walk right over to their location, and provide some culinary arts programming and some just arts programming in general. So it's sparking a lot of different interests in kids, and we're really trying to instill that into the young people now, is really giving them opportunities that maybe they might not have, or those collaborations where we can offer more to the kids that come, and it's all free.
Right, and like you said, there's so much to do in this community. There's so many activities. There's no reason that a child should be sitting home alone on a computer or a phone. They should be out and about and enjoying this beautiful weather and the natural resources that are right here in our own backyard.
Exactly. I mean, one of the cool programs that we run during the summer is the Ultimate Journey program,
mm-hmm.
which is an outdoor science exploration. So,
yes.
We take kids, out in the community and out in the wilderness and do tree identifications or bug identifications and get kids really interested in the sciences. And we have Ethan O'Brien, who's actually running the program, one of our employees, he's got a passion for it too. And when you have a passion for something, it's easy to, that trickle down effect that the kids have a passion for it. So it's really neat to see, the wide-eyed little kids coming in the building, really excited about what's going on every day, and the staff being excited to work with the kids.
And that noise level.
Yeah, it's
that noise level.
it's pretty loud, especially this time of year.
With 125 kids, yes, it would be very loud.
Well, we're so lucky to have Rotary Park right behind us.
Yes.
And we can utilize that space for Capture the Flag or any other kind of activities that we want to do, have out there. And then, you know, there's also location over by NOAA Building too, where there's a big field over there. And so we've got some really cool areas that we can also take the kids outside. And I know Jen, our unit director, she's getting a bunch of sand that Bedrock is going to be donating to do sandcastle contests behind the building. So we're really excited about some of those things. But there's always something going on at the club.
Summer food program.
And the summer food program. This is one of the bigger initiatives that we run year-round, especially this time of year when the kids are out of school. We're lucky to have that partnership, that can sustain partnership with Feeding Kids Ministry, where we provide food food bags for the kids after school, on the weekends.
Right.
So, you know, that's an awesome opportunity for families. But the food program every day, we're feeding so many kids. And Charlene Duby, our vendor and our caterer, she does such a wonderful job putting everything together for us. it's amazing to see, you know, 95 kids going through a food line every single day, and we provide a snack as well. That's been something that we've been talking in the community as I make presentations and talk with other people and through our social media. People are really forthcoming when it comes to snack donations. We are getting a lot of snacks, and we turn around and give it right to the kids. So
perfect.
It's awesome.
Perfect. And we have about 1 minute to talk about YVC.
YVC, and this program during this time of year is one of the busier programs too. They're really out getting engaged in the community. Catherine Noak, the director of the program, she's almost all 10 sessions are completely filled up with kids, which is just awesome. So, you know, they do intergenerational projects to bike path cleanups to you name it, they're out there helping food packing projects. Doing a lot of things for young people to give back to the community. And it's neat because these kids are around other people that have those kind of same interests, and they're giving back to the community. So,
and you know, I've judged many scholarships, and the first line in a scholarship is tell us your community involvement.
Yeah.
Wow, what a great thing to put on there.
Absolutely.
Can list all the things you've done with YVC.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, we're out of time. I want to thank you very much. And Brad, thanks for, you know, you and your staff are taking such wonderful care of the young people in our community, and keep up the good work. And I'll look forward to, you always say stop in, but 125 kids, I'll just listen to the noise and smell the good smells that come out of the place.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Brad. So good to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
Please stay tuned. I'll be right back with some information from Huron Humane Society following these messages. Hi, welcome back. My next guests are both from Huron Humane Society. I have Paige Hamilton and Allie Heiss. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning. Thanks for having us.
You brought some props today, and they're awfully cute.
We did.
Tell me about the kittens you brought.
This one's Teddy. He is ready to go home this week. And this is his brother Casey that Allie has. He's also available this week. And we have Jolson, Einstein, and Joseph who are ready to go at the end of this month. They are ready to go. And they're all up for adoption, ready to find their forever family.
And you know, they're so beautiful, and they have such unique markings. Mm-hmm. So if you're interested in a cat, what would we have to do to take one of these lovelies home with us?
So you come in and apply, and you fill out the application, and then as long as everything checks out on that, if you rent, we do have to talk to your landlord.
Okay.
And once we get the verbal okay from that, then we do the payment, which is $125, and $75 base price for all of our kittens under 6 months, and then an additional $50 deposit for a spay-neuter voucher for any of the vets in Alpena, and you get the spay or neuter completely for free. And once you have that done, you bring the invoice, you get your $50 back. So $125 first, and then $75 when all is said and done.
You know, they're all socialized, they're pan-trained, and they're fun, and they like to play and have a good time. So,
absolutely.
And you have quite a few kittens right now, correct?
Yes. We have almost 30 right now, and we just had 9 born the other day.
Okay.
So, yeah, we're very, very busy, and, you know, we're adopting them all, but we're getting them in, too. So, definitely kitten season, and we're definitely loving it.
Okay.
We get our kitten fix.
So, Allie, you are an animal technician. What does an animal technician do?
Everything from caring for them, cleaning for them, just playing around with them. Like Paige said, we have to socialize them so that when they do go home with their families, they're able to be around other pets, around other people, and they're already very social animals. So being around them is certainly helping that. We just all-around care. We do maintenance for the building as well, not just for the animals, because it's all about their safety and their health. So that comes with cleaning the rooms as well as the cages and kennels that they're in. Helping families find the right kitten is a big part of my job.
Yes.
I can kind of tell the kind of cat or kitten that they want, so my job is to help them find them that kitten, because we have kittens that are very outgoing, energetic. If they're looking for a more chill, kind of on its own cat, then I have the perfect one. Mm-hmm. So that's mostly what I do.
Okay, and I always say when I go there, they go, pick me, pick me, pick me. It's like, yes. Oh my goodness, it's so hard.
How do you choose? Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And now you have a fundraiser coming up.
We do. I just need to get my sheet out here so I make sure I say the right date. It's Yoga for a Cause with Rebecca and Higher Vibrations. Ooh. At Bayview Park at 7 p.m. And she's doing one July 17th for us. And even whether you're experienced or you have no experience, you're more than welcome to go there. And she says, come here, babe. she says, bring your mat or a large towel, water, a cash or check donation that your heart leads you to pledge. And 100% of the donations will go to each organization.
Oh, that's
so
wonderful.
Yes, July 17th at 7 p.m. It sounds awesome. I've never tried yoga, but I mean, for a good cause, why wouldn't you? You know,
and on the beach and enjoy the sun and the weather
And she does say if it does rain, then they'll have it at their studio, Higher Vibrations, I believe, 118 South Ripley.
Okay, anything else going on there?
Lots, but like Ali said, just cleaning, taking care of the animals.
And what kind of dogs do you have now?
We have a lab mix named Jackie. We have a Walker Basset named Archer. Hi, honey. We have a terrier mix named Malin, a terrier boxer mix named Morgan. We have two chihuahuas, Dory and Bart. We have a terrier mix. And then we have a pit bull, another pit bull. So lots of dogs right now.
And they're ready to be adopted.
Yes, they're all available, and they are all up on our website and waiting to go home.
Hi, and now, if people want to come out and look at animals, but they don't really want to take an animal home, they can come out and play with the cats
absolutely.
And walk dogs.
We appreciate that so much, because, you know, that helps them be socialized, and it gives the animals, you know, something to do, someone to hang out with, and, you know, especially if the dogs going for walks, they love that, especially when it's nice out, and the kittens are always up to play. So we absolutely love when people come and just stop in and spend time there.
Okay, and so to be a volunteer, you stop by and fill out a volunteer application, mm-hmm. and then when you're ready to volunteer, they just tell you when to come, or how does that work?
They do it on their own schedule.
Okay.
So they just come in on their own schedule, and we have a little sign-in sheet they can sign in, and, we have some people who just volunteer just to walk dogs, you know, or we have people who volunteer just to clean, or, you know, or sometimes it's a mix of both, and, you just come in on your free time and say, hey, I'm so-and-so, I'm here to volunteer, I have X amount of time to spend here, and we'll definitely find you something to do. We're always looking for help.
And Allie, you mentioned cleaning. When I go there, I'm amazed at how clean that place is.
Oh, yep, constant cleaning.
It's so clean. Mm-hmm. The floors are spotless, the walls are spotless. It's just the cleanest place an animal shelter I've ever been to.
Yes. We owe a lot to our volunteers as well. They do a lot of help with cleaning, and even if they're just out walking the dogs or playing with the cats, then that gives us technicians mm-hmm. time to go around and clean out
Absolutely.
For the kittens and the dogs. So it's very helpful. Any help we can get definitely goes a long way.
And supplies, you're always in need of supplies too.
Yep.
What kind of things could people drop off that you can use?
Oh, anything from laundry detergent. We go through a lot of laundry. We clean their blankets and bedding every single day, day and night. Laundry sheets, the dryer sheets, we need a lot of those. Garbage bags.
Bleach,
yes.
A lot of bleach.
A lot of bleach, litter boxes.
Yeah. Yep.
All of that is very helpful.
Yeah, grain-free food is what we use. So we always take that.
And wet food, I know for the cats, wet food's good.
Yep. We use Science Diet right now, but some of it we use wet food for them. Even if you have donations, even if it's not grain-free, we do put it in our food pantry.
Right,
so
and
that's
when someone adopts an animal too, if they can't afford food right away, you can help
them
with that.
Or you know, if you're struggling, you're going through a rough time and you need help, or say you don't get paid until next week, you need dog food, come on by, we will definitely help you out. If we have it there, we're more than happy to give it out. So even, like I said, even if it's not grain-free, you please still donate it, and we will put it to really good use.
And as you said, Allie, if anyone out there listening or watching is interested, it likes to do laundry, that's the place to go.
Oh, yes,
that
absolutely.
Washer and dryer are going 24 hours a day, I swear. Oh my goodness, there's so much laundry that gets done there.
Yeah, all the time.
And it's so beneficial and so helpful to come and do it, throw it in the dryer and fold up a load and then throw another load in and keep it going and help out.
Yep, like I said, every little bit helps. We have people that just kind of like to stay in the laundry room, mm-hmm. and there's so much just to do in there. So, I mean, going
busy.
From, oh yeah, like dishes. We have a big dish tub in there, drying dishes, sheets and everything, throwing them in the washer, transferring them to the dryer, then folding it, and then delivering them to the rooms that they go to. So just that alone is a big help if we get people in there.
Okay, well, unfortunately, we're out of town. Time. Not out of town, we're out of time. I want to thank both of you very much for being here. And thank you so much for taking such wonderful care of all the animals in our community.
Of course. Come take one of them home.
Yes, please.
Stay tuned for Dr. Don McMaster following these messages.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm Dr. Don McMaster. I'm president of Alpena Community College, and I'm very pleased to have as our guest this morning Barb Ciesniak, my colleague in the president's office. Barb, this is your last day at ACC. We're going to miss you terribly. You know, you've been, 10 years at the college?
Yes.
And then a number of years at the hospital working for Mr. McVitie and Mr. Moe?
Yes, 10 years I was at the hospital also.
And then you were at Delta College?
Early, yes, before we moved back to Alpena, I had 10 years in it. Delta College, I guess that's the magic number, but
I guess so.
I was just going to say that allowed me to get my job at the hospital and eventually move to the college.
Your view of community colleges in general?
Well, as you know, I love community colleges and I try to promote them whenever I can. I was able to get my associate's degree at the age of 45 from Delta College, and it played a huge role in the rest of my career. Allowed me to get the job at the hospital and also the job at the college at ACC. My daughters, my husband, my granddaughters have all gone to community colleges, and I just think it offers that 2 years for students to gain maturity if they need it. It's a wonderful place for non-traditional students like myself who did not do well at a four-year university when they were 18 years old. Mm-hmm. And when the president or admissions person at Western Michigan said to look to your right and turn and look to your left on the orientation day, and one of those people will not be here next year, unfortunately I was the one, but it proved to be a good thing in the end. So
fortunate for us.
Came back to ACC, met my husband in the halls of Van Leer Hall, and just is a great asset to any community and to students who attend. In fact, at Michigan Tech, when my granddaughter was studying chemical engineering, her professors told her that she would be a better student for having attended a community college. So I thought that was a real kudos to our college and all community colleges.
Absolutely. I share your view. Community colleges are so integral, and Alpena Community College in particular. We've loved having your granddaughters there. And they're just thriving. So I have to share with you, I was talking, I think maybe I did, but I want to share it with the viewers. I was talking with Al Moe. We're on the Sanctuary Advisory Committee, and we were talking about you. And he said, he just couldn't speak more highly of your work, and I, of course, agreed with him. And he said, Barbie, that's what he calls you, was one of those people who really understood how every job and every task and really could do it probably herself, and in many cases did. So I would share that view. And your time at the hospital was very, there was a lot going on there at that time.
Yes, there was. We had good times. It was a great a great group with Al and John McVitie and Don Reynolds, and of course my co-workers Barb Beamish and Kay Gagne, who had been longtime Alpena ladies and had worked at the bank before coming to the hospital. Mm-hmm. They were very smart, knew a lot about the community, knew a lot of people, and that was very helpful to me. Coming back after 20 plus years, yeah. You know, you forget who people are, and they're great ladies. So,
well, one of your major roles at the college was working as the administrative assistant for the foundation, and I think a lot of folks don't realize how integral the ACC Foundation is to the operation of Alpena Community College. The two main activities, I guess, being scholarship support for students and fundraising for capital campaigns. And, you know, you've been in the mix on that over 10 years and especially, you know, the last 18 months. Reflect on that role a little bit and the role of the foundation.
Well, the foundation is the fundraising arm of the college, and the board is made up of citizens of Alpena from a wide variety of backgrounds and who support the college for one reason or another, and they're very committed to the college and to the foundation. And yes, I've been through two capital campaigns, interesting process, and it's amazing the support that the Alpena community has for the college. And the best part of the job, I guess, is working with the director of the foundation in establishing scholarships. And that's my biggest love is the students, and we always have a few favorites and that we follow, and it's fun to see where they go or how they're doing, and provides support to them. Students who may not have financial means of going to college, mm-hmm. but also students who don't qualify for federal funded programs but still need assistance with finances. And so it plays an integral part of the college's mission and goals, and so it's been a wonderful 10 years. It was a wonderful 10 years at Delta. The college or the hospital was a different type of entity, but you're still helping patients and families move through the quagmire of healthcare.
Yeah.
But my love is foundation work, and I'm going to miss that, and I'm going to miss the employees at the college. They were they're a great giving group, and were very kind to me when I went through my breast cancer. Were very kind to Penny when she mm-hmm. was battling hers, and it's a good place to work.
Wonderful.
So.
I agree. We're going to miss you. It's been great working with you. Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, thank you, folks, for watching Talk of the Town. We'll see you again next week.
This has been Talk of the Town with your host, Nancy Smitham and Dr. Don McMaster. For a list of community events taking place in Northeast Michigan, please visit our website at WBKB11.com and click on our community link. This has been a Thunder Bay Broadcasting Corporation production. Thank you.